You owe me. My love novel audiobook. Chapter 1. I am counting on your unhappy life. Your husband and I are in room 1108 of Shangri-La, doing what we love to do. Byrong, why won't you just get a divorce? Are you that cheap? You couldn't keep his body nor his heart. Byrong stood in front of room 1108 with an indifferent expression as she looked at the text message on her phone. Her long eyelashes covered the darkness in her eyes as she showed no emotion. The sound of the door opening could be heard. Su Shuyan came out with his arms wrapped around his charming assistant. He paused as he saw Byrong, and then smiled at her. Did you come to catch me cheating again? Why don't you come in? It's so hot outside. Aren't you tired from standing? Byrong looked at him indifferently. I didn't want to spoil your fun. It would be awful if you couldn't direct after seeing me. But is your disease cured already? Su Shuyan had a dull expression when he heard her curse. Byrong, you were the one who was unclean. Why are you being so sarcastic now? Byrong laughed, feeling her tears would flow out anytime. 3 years ago, his ex-girlfriend kidnapped her. While she tried to escape, her virginity was taken by a masked man. At the same time, she watched as Su Shuyan's car stopped nearby. He was having sex with a woman in the car, and that woman was the kidnapper. She felt her heart being stabbed with a knife as she watched the car shake wildly. She could even tell the timing of each thrust from it. She didn't know how she had come over that day, and could still feel the pain whenever she thought about it. I'm sorry if it makes you feel uncomfortable. I'm used to being sarcastic like this. Byrong raised her chin lazily. Su Shuyan had a cold look in his eyes. What are you doing here? Don't tell me you are just here to spoil my fun. I'm afraid you are right. Your intuition has always been spot on. Byrong smiled calmly. Piss off, Su Shuyan said angrily. Byrong retrieved a document from her bag and handed it to Su Shuyan. Su Shuyan did not take it and asked her cautiously, what is this? About her. Byrong glanced at Su Shuyan's assistant. What about me? The assistant wrapped her arms around Su Shuyan's. She had heard that Byrong was his wife, who was never favored by the man at all. In fact, Su Shuyan seemed to be disgusted by her today. So she had nothing to fear. Byrong waved the document in her hand. You are the infamous filthy secretary of Su City. 80% of the wealthy businessmen in Su City have slept with you. And one of them was diagnosed with AIDS last month. The secretary's face went deathly pale. Byrong then turned to look at Su Shuyan. You did use condom, right? If not, I know a doctor. Would you like me to introduce him to you? Su Shuyan took the document from Byrong, narrowed his eyes and shot her a fierce look as he threw it at her face. You always have a way of making people unhappy. Byrong stood straight. When the paper hit her on the face, it hurt more than she expected. She sneered, you know me. I'm counting on you to spend the rest of your life unhappy. Then for me to be happy, I must do something that makes you even more unhappy. I won't go home today, so you don't have to wait for me. Su Shuyan said angrily. He turned around and walked towards the elevator. Byrong just stood there with an indifferent look on her face. She knew what he meant when he said not to wait for him. He would be spending the night at another woman's place, getting their scent on him. Ever since she lost her virginity, he had never touched her again. In his eyes, she was no better than a filthy secretary. A mist gradually formed in her cold eyes. She didn't cry or complain, but she still felt the pain. Su Shuyan's assistant slapped her on the face. Byrong was caught off guard. She took a few steps back and leaned against the wall. UB**** You think you can win his heart over by ruining me? The assistant clenched her fists angrily. I don't even want that scumbag's heart. Byrong slapped the assistant back on the face. I'm not someone you can mess with. Then why won't you get a divorce? The assistant shouted. You don't have the right to know that yet. This information will be exposed on the internet tomorrow. Take care, Byrong said coldly, and walked out of the hotel. It was late at night. She pulled her clothes tighter, and walked on the empty road while the moonlight stretched her shadow. She felt lonely. Going home would only make her feel even more uncomfortable. She decided to sleep in the hospital's duty room. As she entered the office, she switched on the light. A soldier in a green uniform ran over with a solemn expression and asked anxiously, "Are you the gynecologist on duty?" His anxiousness made Byrong uneasy as well. "What's wrong? How could I help you?" "A pregnant woman is held hostage nearby, and her water just broke. The situation is very critical and requires immediate medical attention. Please come with me," the soldier said urgently. It was indeed very dangerous for a pregnant woman if her water broke. Byrong didn't have time to think. "I'll go with you after I get my first aid kit. Give me 5 minutes." Soon after, she followed the soldier to a garden complex near the hospital. There were about a dozen soldiers standing there with a solemn look on their faces. They were well trained as they stood still while waiting for instructions from their superiors. Byrong was led into room 802, which was opposite to room 801 where the event was taking place. At a glance, she could see a man giving out commands. He had a tough-looking face and a sharp look in his eyes. His facial features were like a perfect artwork in the hands of a sculptor. Shockingly handsome. She was curious about the men who were listening to him attentively. Among them was a colonel with 3 epaulets on his shoulders. Wouldn't that make him the general then? The man's sharp gaze shifted towards her. Byrong was taken aback and lowered her head. He walked straight towards her, and the tall shadow formed by his huge figure enveloped her oppressively. This reminded her of the masked man from that night, as he had a similarly strong build as well. So it was pointless for her to struggle. "Raise your head," Gu Mingchen ordered. His eagle-like eyes stared at her delicate face, and his tight lips gave him an angry look. Under his pressure, Byrong lifted her head to look at him. His face looked cold and his sharp eyes instilled fear in people. This was the first time she had seen a man able to strike fear into others without even having to speak. "I'm a doctor, not a criminal," Byrong said. A light flashed in Gu Mingchen's eyes as he ordered his subordinates sternly, "Let her go, and bring in someone else." Byrong didn't understand. "What's wrong with me? We're up against 3 drug cartel bosses in there who would kill without any hesitation. Do you have the guts to go in there?" Gu Mingchen asked. "Why wouldn't I?" Byrong shot back. Gu Mingchen frowned and grabbed her chin as he leaned closer. "Think carefully before you answer me. This isn't a drill, and the chances of you making it out alive is extremely slim." His presence was overwhelming as he breathed down on her lips. Byrong was as stubborn as an ox. The more someone looked down on her, the more she wanted to prove herself. "I wouldn't have come here if I was afraid of dying," she answered directly as she looked at him straight in the eyes fearlessly. Gu Mingchen frowned as he stared at her. His pupils were so dark that she could see her own reflection in them. Welcome to download the Bravanovel app. Read the novel you owe me. My Love Online and get the latest updates.